two things. We've got a couple phone calls. Is this mass? No, this is not mass. This is an old tradition in Christianity where lessons, meaning scripture, and carols, songs about the birth of the Savior, were brought together because on Christmas Day we celebrate the Word of God leaping down from heaven. And so lessons and carols became a way to really, really say on the third Sunday of Advent with the pink candle that Christmas is almost here. So it's about putting us into this joyful mood and also helping us to become more and more aware of really what the Christmas celebration is about. Everybody's busy. Everybody's busy. Everybody's about shopping. But the bottom line is, we're here tonight, these young people, our adult choir young people, who are here to help us become more focused about what this great feast is about. And how about these kids putting us in this room and this adult choir?
Child to lead them. lies out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make straight through the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken.
Thank you. Just when he had determined to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Mary had been told by the angel Gabriel, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. Mary responded, here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word.
Oh,
Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and she was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. She gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in man's cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Thank you.
and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph, and the child lying in a manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child. All who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had taken place and been told to them.
Among the rulers of Judah.
the wise men, and learned from them the exact time when the star appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word, so that I may also go and pay homage." When they heard the king, they set out. There ahead of them went the star they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They knelt down and gave him homage. Then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Thank you.
Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light that shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory,